Right, now we're on again. So let's talk about this very hard subject where about satanistic rituals. You have had at least two people who have had it.
Yeah.
And should we start with one of them first?
Yeah,
okay.
Well, a German lady came to visit me because she was suffering from severe traumas and she could actually not remember exactly what had happened to her. It was all very vague, but she knew that she was not all right and she wanted to know more about herself and what happened to her.
How old was she?
I think she's 50, around 50 years
50?
Old.
And when did she experience the rituals?
That was what we didn't know. I mean, we didn't know, she didn't know herself also. We didn't know nothing. I also didn't know
anything. She didn't remember the rituals?
Nothing.
Okay.
We both didn't, I didn't know nothing from her, and the only thing she said to me, I did already so much trauma therapy and things, but I still have so much trauma in me. I don't understand where it's coming from. And I really like to find out with the ayahuasca what it's all about. Okay, so then we started to drink for the first time. And then I already see that she had so much entities. So much entity. I mean, we haven't even started half an hour, or I saw already entities coming, and I could only liberate her from entities. There were layers of entities, and I was, God, I don't know what this lady had been going through, and I also didn't get an answer. But I saw that there were so much entities in every chakra, and I did nothing else than cleaning and spitting it out. And I was attacked myself also, and I had to pray a lot with a pipe, and it was quite heavy, everything. And I said, okay, but in that moment, neither she nor me knew anything from satanic ritual abuse or whatever.
Mm.
The first time was only like layers of entities cleaning out of
time. When was this in time? Was it 2 years ago?
No, it was last year.
Last year.
So then she went home, and I said, okay, just see how you feel and how, if it gets any better and this and that. And then, after a month she wrote me, she said, I have still these very strange dreams and I feel not good yet, and I really think that I need another session. Yes.
What kind of dreams did she have?
I don't remember. I don't remember. I know that she had...
Was it dreams
negative.
Of the rituals?
We both still didn't know nothing. So the first time it was not revealed at all to us.
Oh yes, okay.
That can happen, eh? Then the second time, we started again with the ceremony, and then we went to work deeper, and then I and she, somehow we get revelations that because she knew well, she knew she was sexually abused by the father. That was already something she knew, that we knew already before.
Yes.
And then we saw that, and she also said that all the other children from the family also had been sexually abused by the father. Okay, that was already a fact that we knew. And then I started to treat her again, and then somehow I got revelations that the father was a member of a satanic sect in Germany, and that he secretly had bring his daughter when she was a baby to this sect to do all kind of rituals with her.
Yes.
And it was Archangel Michael who showed that to me, that was happened, and that was her problem. Now that was another also very serious session, of course, because then we went really into the deep layers of the ritual abuse. The first session was that it was only like layers of entities which were somehow around it.
Yeah.
But now it came really to the core of the problem, and that was Yeah, that was this sexual abuse as a baby, being into that sect, but they also had put all kind of curses on her, so that she would never be happy, and all kind of satanic curses have been done on her, and I had to take it all out. It was very, very heavy with the Archangel Michael.
But it could be done. You could remove this curses?
Yeah, it was very serious. I mean, I don't want to say I was afraid, but it was heavy, and very heavy, because curses is also were connected with demons. So it was nothing else than taking demons out and bad curses, and then I had to run outside and throw immediately the entities outside and go back. It was very serious. The Archangel Michael also didn't want to leave any energy or trace or whatever in the room, so I had all the time to clean the room, and it was serious. Yeah. Okay, so then we thought, okay, now we've come to the core of the thing, and everything is out, and I cleansed her as good as possible. And then the Archangel Michael said she has to come back in 2 weeks.
Okay,
we're still not there. Yeah, according to, okay, 2 weeks later she come again, and then we found out, because many of the demons were already gone, but then she saw reptilians next to her in the ceremony, like watching her. You know, reptilians is an alien race, and they are very connected with satanic ritual abuse. That goes together, the alien reptilians. She said, yeah, I'm seeing that I'm watched by a reptilian. And I know, of course, all the stories about reptilian.
Yeah.
So then the first thing the Archangel Michael did was pushing his sword in that reptilian, and he
threw you.
Yeah, threw my arm. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then he fell away. And then we were working on the chakras, and then we saw that in that each chakra was somehow connected with a device. It went somewhere into the astral world or whatever. Oh. And she said, but I am feeling that I am part of an experiment.
Oh.
And everywhere there was on her throat there was something, and in the heart there was something, and all kind of things that I've of course never seen before, because I'm not used to this type of things. And she said that she felt that she has been used in an experiment. Yes. But I don't know what kind of experiment it was. Maybe.
Could you say what people it was? Was it Americans that did it, or was it Germans?
This happens in Germany. This satanic ritual abuse happens in Germany. So there, this have happened. I mean, there is. But I think with the satanic rituals, then reptilians also come in the space or so, and they like to experiment on human beings. And maybe they just wanted to see how much somebody can have, or if somebody can still be normal after all this, or I don't know what.
So she noticed this reptilian.
Yeah.
Did you see it as well? Or you just...
Not really with my physical eyes, but she said, I'm seeing a reptilian standing next to me, watching how this is going, this whole healing and this experiment, because she's part of his experiment, I think.
Yeah.
And at that moment, I realized, oh, but that is possible, because these reptilians are very related to the satanic ritual, because I normally don't see them in my sessions. And at the same moment, the Archangel Michael grabbed his sword and so next to her.
Yeah.
And then it was gone. I said, do you see him? She said, no, I don't see him anymore.
But you think that obviously this reptilian tried to stop what you were doing?
I don't know, stop, or maybe just observe. They sometimes only observe if it's possible to release somebody. Maybe that's what they want to know.
Yeah.
That if they already do all these things on somebody, if it's still possible that a healer or somebody can liberate somebody like this.
Yes. So the connection she had in her chakras Did you, could you remove them?
Yeah.
You could?
Yes.
Was that difficult, or was it, could that be done with pranic healing, you think?
No, I don't think so. This was all done
by Michael.
Very strongly by the Archangel Michael, taking out these devices. They were like, like in a laboratory, like buisjes, what is that, the name of that?
It's like what you have on your heart, when you measure your heart.
Something like that, but everywhere. She had also something on the throat, was completely like, oh, and there was something going here, and every, in all chakra was something that connected her to a certain, let's say, experiment, like maybe measuring, you know, the energy of the chakras or the energy of the pure, I don't know, something like that.
Yes. And so then you have released. When did you notice about this sexual abuse? When do you get
that? Was the first time already that she told
me.
She knew that. I mean, the sexual abuse happened a long time, maybe till her 13, 14 or whatever. So she remembered that.
But the rituals.
That came later.
Then?
Now it was revealed to me by the Archangel Michael, and she accepted it somehow. It was. I don't think if she really consciously remembered it, but she said it was all possible.
So you, Archangel Michael, told you
about
what
happened. Yeah, but
that
happens a lot. But that happens a lot, not only with her, but with many other people. When there is very serious problems that we don't know, he tell me what is the problem of that person. Also, somebody that has been cursed severely, or. That she don't know it, me also don't know it, Archangel Michael has to tell me then this is going on, and this is what we're going to heal.
And so after that session, what happened then?
That was the third time, and then we released all these devices and things, and all the demons were also already gone and out, and she have everywhere protection, and then I went to Gambia, but she wrote me, she said she had a feeling she was 99% healed.
Oh, yeah. So she was really happy. Yeah. It was amazing.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
But you didn't tell what families it was, what sect it was.
I think she also don't know it. She don't know because the mother was very, let's say, normal and straightforward, and it was only the father who did all this in secret. I think the wife even didn't know it.
Oh, okay. Because many times it's both the father and the mother.
I had this idea in her situation that it was only the father that...
But all the children was abused.
They were abused by him, and maybe also taken to the...
Because many times the experimenters, they want families like this that they can take the children from.
It is terrible. It's terrible. It's unbelievable. Yes.
It's really unbelievable that they don't stop it. I mean, it's not that hard to figure out what family it is. It just go there. Like, it's not hard for the police to figure out what family it is. It's not that secret. It's just that they are so powerful that the police can't get to them, I would say.
I also understand. Don't understand it.
But exposure like this, they must really hate. I mean.
Yeah, but it should even be more.
Yeah,
like I told you about that other lady who has been raised in a satanic sect. She really should expose it. That people have been so severely abused and tortured and whatever that they don't have the fit.
Yes.
She was at the point of committing suicide. Yeah, I said, before you commit suicide, then please, expose who did all this.
Yeah. Yes, of course. So, should we talk about the English girl?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. And she has been through this all from the beginning.
Yeah.
Until she got about 20 years old. Okay.
So there was an English girl that seek my help. And wrote me that she had been raised and born in a satanic sect. The family was there, the father, the mother, the children, they all were in the sect. And I think she never had any normal life. I don't know if she went to school, I have no details about that, but I know that what she write to me, that was that she was all the time tortured and brainwashed and manipulated, and that she has been witnessing a lot of satanic ceremonies where people have been killed, and yes, and they try to force these children also to kill somebody, you know, like this is all, yes, what they do with these people. And that some things were so, you know, terrible that she can even remember it. And that probably have to do that she didn't have split personalities.
Yeah. She was about 35.
Something like, she was quite young. She was in a terrible state. I mean, she must be full with entities and demons and split personalities. She could not work. She had sought help everywhere, also from, I don't know, Christian faith healers and all these things, and nothing had helped her. And yeah, she was quite desperate.
Yes, but you could help her?
No.
Okay.
No, I mean, it's only recently, in the first place, that she wrote to me. She lived in England. I'm now in Gambia.
Yeah.
And the Archangel Michael said, for the moment, this person is too difficult to treat because they have split personalities.
Yes.
It means that you start to work on with the ayahuasca on the normal personality. But then it goes away, and then it comes another personality which is totally possessed by a demon or whatever. And I cannot handle that.
Yes.
Then she probably will do nothing else than screaming, and like what you see in exorcism films, you know, like somebody that screams only, and yeah, you have to chain them, and I don't know what, I'm not ready for that.
Yes, yes. How does she live right now? Does she live alone?
Or
does,
yeah, she live alone. I told her about pranic healing. I said, start with that to clean out already, yes, the chakras, and yes, maybe they can do something for you.
Maybe she should wear a watch. That's a that's an important thing, because if you have a split personality, you need to organize your life.
Yeah, yeah.
She should write down all the memories in a day in a book. There are some things when you read about Kathy O'Brien,
yeah,
Transformation of America, what she did when she recovered, what her husband helped her with. First, her husband. I really recommend this book to everybody, Transformation of America, but I don't recommend it to young people. You have to be at least 30 years old or something, because it's horrible. But the thing that the husband did, he took her away and went to Las Vegas and married her. And then they escaped to Alaska. But she was really not capable of doing this herself. He almost had to steal her from her owners. And then she started with a watch to know the time of the day, so she can notice how when she's away and not. And then she also wrote down all her memories. So maybe she should read her book, and maybe, yeah, how to come back.
Yeah,
very interesting. Okay.
Yeah,
so
I recommended her, but she was, yeah.
Yeah, it's not easy when you are. You really need a person, I guess, all the
time
along with you. Yes. But tell me more about her. What did she experience? How was the rituals?
I don't know. Like, she didn't go into detail. I only had email contact with her.
Okay.
So she didn't go too deep into it.
But why is she still alive? I think they have to be afraid that she exposes these things.
No, that's what I told her to do.
Yes.
I said, now listen, you know, all the damage that's been done to you, I don't know if there's any help for you, if we can help you, but at least you can expose it. Expose, yes, these people, make it known who is doing this.
Yes.
What is the name of this sect, what is this?
But it's very dangerous to do it. I wouldn't recommend her doing it alone. Like Kathy O'Brien, she had a husband that was former CIA, I think.
Oh.
Very, very powerful. And that's why they couldn't get to her. If she wouldn't have him, they would have killed her, I think. So this woman really have to be really careful. I mean, maybe expose it in secret first. And just give out a book or something, but nobody will print the book. But maybe give it out on the internet. Maybe do interviews. But the most important is to get here.
There are also, I know, quite in Holland, for example, very independent publishers.
Yes.
That have published books also about this, about 13 families, you know, all what they did, you know, they are publishers, the publishers that publish this.
Okay, perhaps she can, but I feel it's very dangerous. She should really be careful. But maybe the most important thing is for her to heal herself first. Yeah. So she will come back to you, you think?
I don't think so, because I cannot help her in this moment with the ayahuasca and I found it also very, very heavy to work with a person like this, and I also have a lot of other clients.
Yes.
I have a lot of other things, you know. I'm like a general healer. I not even wanna specialize myself in satanic ritual abuse because it's very, very heavy.
Yes, very heavy.
I mean, if it comes on my path, okay, but I not really want to encourage everybody who has satanic ritual abuse to come to me, because I mean,
it's hard work. Yeah, yeah. Okay, great. We take a pause.